Our energy clients today are facing a lot of disruptions and pressure and a number of new opportunities. So if I were to separate those two, on the disruption side, every segment of the industry is facing some disruptions in some form. So whether or not that's the pressure on return on capital from investors, whether it's on the downstream side of their business, so for fuels marketing, the rise of autonomous fleets and how do they serve those customers? Do they serve them in the same way? To fuel delivery service, to what's their position with fuels retailers as well? And so across those, they're facing a number of challenges. Then, of course, there's always the political environment that causes disruptions in the market and will cause fluctuations in the price of crude, which impacts the entire chain. And then you're seeing some of the companies start to take new action in how they think about themselves. And so if you look at companies like Equinor, who changed their name even, or you look at others like BP and Shell, who are very publicly talking about their investments in electricity, for example, or in renewables, you're starting to see a change in dynamic that means not only are those companies having to think about what does that mean for them, all their competitors have to think about what does that mean for them as well in terms of how they show up in the marketplace. And so, it is both a challenging market to be in, but on the other side, you're starting to see new opportunities rise with these new customers coming into play and, new markets that they're entering into that are exciting for them and for their employees. And then you have things like digital technology, which is really allowing them to do things in a different way. So for some of our oil field services customers, that allows them to open up new lines of business to provide data as a service, or to provide insights as a service. For our fuels marketing customers, they actually get better insights into what do their end consumers want and how do they better serve them so that, it's not just you're pulling up to any gas station, but actually you have an experience around that you find, fulfilling. So, there are great opportunities that they have for change in this environment as well. And then there are some big global dynamics that have been changing. And so the United States production has increased significantly over the last 10 years. And now we are becoming a net exporter over time, and which that means that now there are new markets that some of the more US-focused companies can pursue. There's exports of LNG that they're looking at. There's, how do they better serve some of the growth markets around the world? And so, there are great opportunities and also challenges. And what that means is that for us as a partner, as Capgemini, we need to think about, for our unique capabilities and skill sets, how do we help our clients navigate some of these competing opportunities and challenges at the same time in a way that's going to help them be sustainable in the long term.